Hello everyone. Can you see anything in this video? No, right? Because there is no light in this room. When I switch on the light falls on me and you can see light travel from the tube light to me. You can see whenever you throw a ball on the ground. Suppose this is you and you are throwing a ball. The path taken by the ball is like this. It may bounce and it may go. But how does light travel? Light travels in straight lines. This can be understood by this simple activity. Take a candle and make three holes in the cardboard. Make sure that all the three holes are in the straight line. Then look from the last cardboard. You can still see light from the candle. Okay, and there is another activity. Take a pipe and pass a light beam through it. You can see the light beam coming from the another end. But take another pipe or the same pipe, you just bend it and pass it. But when you see then you can see that when it is bent, there is no light coming from the another end. So this proves that light travels along straight line. Now that you have seen light travels in straight line, let us know what happens when there is an object in between its path. It's in between the source of light and the paper. We can see the light falling on it. But when I put a pencil over here, you can see that there is a shadow because it is an opaque object. Now, if I put a transparent cover here, so you can see that that light still passes through the cover. But today we will see what will happen when we put a mirror in the path of light. Okay, so you can see that there is an image formed, right? Image of the torch. Here, morning, each and every morning, you get up, get ready to school and go. At that time, what you do? You look yourselves in the mirror, right? That there is an image of yours formed, right? So now we are going to see the properties of image formed in a plane mirror. In the first activity over here, we have a plane mirror, okay? It is fixed to this board and we will have this pawn over here, right? I will mark its position, okay? And I'll put it back here. I will try to look at the pawn from another angle. Suppose it's like this. And I'll try to insert two sticks in front of the image. Okay. And I have to see that both the pins are in the straight line. Now I remove the plane mirror and the pins, as I have already marked the position of the object over here. What I do is I join the lines, these two lines are connecting the two pins. Okay, I extend it beyond where the mirror was there and I draw a perpendicular line to the mirror which was kept here, right? I draw a perpendicular line over here and I extend it to the behind of the mirror. There is a point where the two lines meet. That is the point where our image was formed. Okay. So from here we can see that. Now we can see that from this point, the length of the distance of the object from the mirror is equal to the distance of the image from the mirror. So this was our result from the previous activity, and that was a plane mirror. Now let us see what happens when we curve the mirror. See, here it is a plane mirror, right? I put it over here and there is a grid in front of it and I pass light through the grid. Now you can see that light travels in straight line and none of the light rays intersect because it is a plane mirror. Now, so if I curve the mirror, The same mirror has been curved here, and this is a concave mirror, and you can see that there is a point where the light rays intersect. Now what I have done is I have made that plane mirror into a convex mirror. Now let us see what are the results. When I pass the light through the grid, you can clearly see that the reflected rays are diverging. That means they are moving away from each other. But whereas in the concave mirror, what happened is all the reflected rays met at one point and we had a single point over there. But here there are nothing like that because all the rays are diverging. Here, if you observe carefully, these reflected rays appear to meet behind the mirror. So the focus point for a convex mirror is behind the mirror, and for a concave mirror is in front of the mirror. When I pictorially describe all the three situations, the first one is the plane mirror, right? Here, the incident ray went, hit to the surface of the, that is a reflecting surface, and traced its path back again. So there was no focus point seen. But in the concave mirror, what happened is the light rays which hit the reflecting surface reflected the rays in such a way that there was a common point for all of them to meet, that too in front of the mirror. That is where the focus point was. But in the convex mirror, what happened is all the light rays which came and hit the reflecting surface, they diverse. That means they move away from each other. So when these lines are extended or extrapolated backwards, what happens is we find a focus point behind the mirror, which is imaginary. So we have seen that light travels in straight line and light can reflect from objects. So here this is the peak one representing reflection. In the second picture, that is nothing but when you see look through your water bottles or glasses, what happens? There is a bending of light, or we can say that here the image of the object is something different than expected. So here it is refraction, because the light rays are being bent. So now we'll see what happens due to refraction. Here we have a lens. Okay, this is a convex lens and we will use it to make a projector. This is the model of the projector, and when I switch on the light over here, the image which is there on this film is cached over there. Now when I lift this, you can see that the R here is reverse, but when I put it here, the image is the R here is erect, right? This is because whenever a light ray is passed through a lens, what happens is it just reverses the object. Here what we do is keeping the object distance as constant, we can move the screen here and we can see where we get a clearer image. On the top, when you see here, we have some markings, right? These are nothing but the distance. This is the distance between the object and the lens, and this is the distance between the object and the image. To find the focal length of this lens over here, what you can do is focus a distance object like a tree or a house from the window and try to focus the image over here as sharply as possible.